So a lot of fieldwork experience is doing one-on-one interactions with students to just kind of assist the teacher. But as you go along through the program, it becomes more hands-on. And a lot of teachers respect Muhlenberg, so they will trust you to lead a lot of lessons, and you really do get to be the lead teacher of the classroom, and the actual teacher is there to support you. So in my last year of fieldwork before student teaching, I really did a lot of actual teaching, and then I would be critiqued by the primary teacher. And I felt like that was great experience that prepared me for student teaching.
That was the first field work where I actually got to be placed in a physics classroom. Not necessarily that, though. He is a very experienced teacher and has a very, very different style of teaching than I've seen anyone else had. His room is literally cluttered with toys and demos that you wouldn't even think existed, and he had things hanging from the ceiling. And while I would look for things like placement in the classroom, is he always moving around? He was almost always doing that without thinking, just to get to everything within the classroom.
The one that really stood out to me was actually at William Allen High School, and it was a 9th and 11th grade classroom. And the reason that it really stood out to me was because it wasn't necessarily the content or the classroom environment, but the teacher that I worked with, he was very, very good at teachable moments, and he actually was able to give the students a lot of insight about life as opposed to just history, and related the topics that he was teaching really well to their lives. And that really stood out to me, and I actually ended up requesting him for student teaching, and I'm student teaching with him now. So that was probably the number one thing that stood out to me in any of my fieldwork placements.
I was at the Hillside School, and that specialized in kids who had just like more minor learning disabilities, like ADD and dyslexias. And I was in a kindergarten, first grade class, and they were great, and they like really broke down the school day. And they did everything from like reading to math to just like knowing what the weather is outside. And it just like kind of broke things down, and that really helped the kids in learning like at their own pace and like in an individual sense. So it was great to see that.
Coming from Warminster, I didn't have a lot of ELL experience as a student, and I had only learned about it as a teaching student. So it was great to see all of the different kind of tactics and teaching pedagogies that we learned about utilized in a classroom setting effectively. And I felt like I did learn a lot in that experience.
The most powerful thing that I've experienced had to do with how the kids responded to me. And I know from my perspective, I always just assumed that since I was only there once a week, the students wouldn't really get to know me. They wouldn't really, I was kind of an outsider. It was just someone who was sitting in the class, and they wouldn't really care all that much that I was in there. But what I learned was just by the little interactions that I had with them, the once a week interactions, I actually developed very positive relationships with a lot of the students in all the fieldworks that I had,